Hello friends, welcome back to Technique YouTube channel. Today we will look at a really super lightweight Raspberry Pi based media center that you can use to watch movies and TV shows on your TV, on your high definition TV rather. So let's get started here. So the first thing that you will need to do is to have a Raspberry Pi board. A Raspberry Pi board, as you know, is a low cost system on chip. So you even if you have a really old version which has like 512 MB RAM and a single core CPU, that's also good for this particular solution that I'm going to show right now. Okay, you can also use the Raspberry Pi Zero motherboard, which is a $5 system on chip computer that you can utilize as a media center. So okay, so let's get started here. OpenELEC. So you need to go to openelec.tv and download the image for Raspberry Pi. So go to the download section, click on Raspberry Pi builds. So it has builds for various media centers. Pick the Raspberry Pi build and pick the Raspberry Pi model that you have. So I have the first generation single core model, so I'm going to pick up this one, and I want the disk image, not the update file. If you have the second generation, then pick the disk image from here. Okay. Usually the stable version works fine, but if you want it even lighter, you could even use the legacy version, which is a real lightweight version. But I prefer the stable version. This is good. Not that legacy is not stable. Legacy is also stable, just that it is old. Okay, so we are going to pick this up. Okay, so it's downloading here. It's a 135 MB file. I already have this downloaded, so I'll quickly open the downloaded file here now. Okay, so here it is. Here's the downloaded file here. So the first thing you need to do after you've downloaded it is to open it in a archiving software. Like, it's not the usual zip archive that you can open on Windows directly. It's a gzip. So gzip, for gzip you will need something like a WinRAR or UnRAR. So download that solution if you don't have. If you're unable to open the gzip file, download WinRAR and then extract this image file out there. Okay, so we have the image file now. Now what we need to do is to write this image file on a 1 GB SD card. So here's the SD card, I have inserted it, and I have chosen 1 GB because I really want to emphasize that this is a super lightweight solution, right? You can't get any lower than this. So we are going to write it on a 1 GB SD card. So let's so you can't simply copy this image file onto the SD card. You have to burn it on as a bootable image, right? So for that you need another solution. So we'll quickly go there and download that solution. I use Rufus. This is a really good solution to create bootable pen drives and SD cards, but you could use any of these that are written on the Rufus website. Unit Bootin, Universal USB Installer. I've used all of these, and all of these are good. They are near about the same, but I like Rufus better. Just a personal choice. So I'm going to download Rufus here. Just 945 KB. So again, this is also super lightweight. Okay, less than an MB. So we've got Rufus here, right? In fact, I have all these in my repository of tools that I keep. But anyway, since we've downloaded it here, I'll run it from here now. So let's run it here. Okay, so this is how a Rufus layout would look like. The first and foremost thing, most important thing that you need to make sure is that you have chosen the right SD card here that needs to be written onto. If you find your hard drives here or any of your other pen drives which are plugged into your machine, if you chose that, they will get all the data there will get damaged permanently. So you are, if you chose the hard drive, obviously your computer will crash. So you don't want to do any of that. Okay, just make sure you have the right SD card chosen. That's why I named the SD cards very intuitively. I've named it SD1 GB so that I know that I'm writing to the SD card. Okay, so here it is. Now you don't have to worry about all these other stuff. Just ignore. Just come down all the way to create a bootable disk using, and here choose ISO image and pick up the ISO image using this button. The ISO image is the image of the file which we had just downloaded at the beginning of this video, right? So I don't see it here because that was an IMG file, and here it is only allowing ISO. So we'll just choose all files. Now you can see the IMG file which we extracted from the zip file which we had downloaded. Choose that IMG file, and before you click start again, double check that you have chosen the right device where you are writing onto. Okay, SD1 GB, yeah, that's what where I want to write to, and I click start. Okay, it gives the warning which I had been giving you the last all this while. Okay, so it's writing good. So while it writes, let's wait, and once the writing is completed, we are going to take out this drive and this SD card and put it in the Raspberry Pi. Connect the Raspberry Pi to the TV using an HDMI cable, and connect the Pi to a decent power supply which provides at least 1 ampere. So ideally a fast charger for a tablet is the ideal thing that I want to use, or a fast charger for a mobile. In any case, you will need a minimum 1 ampere or 1000 milliampere charger to run a Raspberry Pi as a media center. So find that, connect it, and on the next video we will look at it. Look at the screenshot of the or capture of the TV screen on how this comes up on the TV. What kind of a media center it is? What features it has? It has loads of features. In fact, it's very extensible. You can add YouTube, Hotstar, all those Netflix, all these TV apps, TV and video streaming apps. One thing that it doesn't support is Amazon Prime, because of its Prime has a special encryption that is not supported by Raspberry Pi. But everything else is supported out there. You can also use it for downloading your movies in the background, so you can run jobs to run downloads in the background. All those things are available off the shelf, and you don't have to keep your computer running. It's just a Raspberry Pi board would consume only as much power as a mobile phone. So that's a very lightweight device running out there doing all your work in the background. Okay, so we are near about completed here. Okay, so the image is written. Now you get all these errors. Just forget about those errors. Those are coming because Windows is unable to recognize that disk now that disk has been written in a Raspberry Pi Linux format, right? It's a Unix format. So I'm going to close this here. I'm going to eject and get my SD card out of the system, and I'm going to put it in the Raspberry Pi. So on my next video, we will have the we will see how that performs on the TV. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.